so we're going to make this pattern, butter egg B4669. I'll be making A with the little peak here at C, just this little piece. So I already have, alright, so I've cut all my pieces out. And so first part says, pin interfacing to wrong side, okay. Base notch edges along seam lines and armoring edges in a 3/8 inch seam. So I already did this piece with my, this one. So it pretty much says, if you don't have any notches, you do 3/8 of an inch. And if you do have a notch, you can't really see my notch, does it? You do have a notch right here, and you do 5/8 of an inch. So we're going to do that for pieces 1, 2, and 3. So when you do a basting stitch, you make sure that your length of the stitch is very long, and then 3/8 of an inch. If you're new, I suggest you would make lines, but I'm just going off of my sewing machine, this 3/8 right there. So I just align it and I sew it. It's not aligned right now, but you get the point. So that's what you do. You don't backstitch or anything. You just do a straight long line. And then here where you see a notch, I'm going to make this one 5/8, so I'm going to move it more on this side. Alright, so step 3 says E-stitch side edge of front between small circles. So my first circle is already underneath my foot, and here's my second circle. So what you're going to do is you're kind of going to do like a basting stitch. Make sure you have a lot of string stitch with a long stitch all the way to here, and when you cut, you also leave a long piece of string. So our next step says stitch back and front sections together at shoulders. So you're going to grab this notch, make sure it's right side to right side, and bring it over. Match these notches, and you're going to sew it right on this seam. And then you're going to do the same thing with the other one on this side. Alright, so I lined my corset. It's different, I didn't have enough fabric. Now the next step says step 13, or sorry, 10, binding. Stay stitch armhole edge of side sections ending at side front seam as shown. To stay stitch, stitch 1/4 inch from raw edge. So I guess can't tell which is the side, the stitching while holding my phone, but look, you're going to stitch. A stay stitch is when you want it, you don't want this to kind of curve when you add another stitch to it. So stay stitching, you don't do a long stitch, you do the normal stitch. And I think you backstitch. So we're going to do that 1/4 from raw edge, all of this through the armhole. So for view A, it says to use continuous bias to make binding using these directions. But when I bought the fabric, I didn't consider buying extra for the binding. I don't even remember. I think I just assumed that it used tape instead of binding, making your own binding. I didn't read the directions or the back piece. So I'm just going to use some double-sided bias tape, and instead of using that, I'm still going to follow all the directions though to finish the corset. Alright, so as you see, we have lining sides together. Here is where I left off. A little messy, sorry. So I sewed on to along the line, and now it says pin remainder of binding to armhole, connecting with previous stitching above large circle. Turn binding to outside over edges based, stitch along basting ending opposite large circle. So I believe now I'm going to cut this to align it with my tape, and then I will fold it over. And then I think you open it up and you sew it. We'll see. So it's kind of weird how I'm filming. So what I did is I caught or folded over my edge. And what I'm trying to do is kind of make it so that it lays flat. And then you're going to sew, continue the seam down. And you have to make sure that this stays flat. Down and flat. So I noticed in the instructions they wanted you to finish the bottom piece first and then do something else, but I am gonna just say now that I'm not gonna follow the final instructions. What I've done, so this is how the back looks. What I've done so far is I added the tape through the neck piece. Finished. Now I'm just going to add tape here on the edges and then finish it by doing tape on the bottom. I would do tape one whole piece, but I'm not sure how I feel about ending up here and especially going upwards on this side. So yeah, so after that I'll probably add the eyelets. And then we're done. Alright, so this is my finished piece. And don't forget to take out all the threads. This is how it looks like in the back. The side. And the inside. I do need to do the holes, but I'm not sure if I'm going to do it embroidered or metal eyelets. So I'm just going to leave it like this for now. So yeah.